guys, it's Jeff here. Thanks for joining me today. My good friend Scott Waters emailed me about 2 weeks ago and asked me if I could take a look at an 8-track tape that he wanted to see if he can get repaired and get it back to playing condition. He said he was going to send a couple along with it that are mine to keep for my troubles, but I'm guessing he must have already had these titles in his collection since they're very good albums from the Bay City Rollers. Is one of them. And The Village People is the second one. And Scott, you know I'm only kidding with you. I know you're not that type of music for you. But I am going to get these playing and get them into the collection because they are 8-tracks and all 8-tracks are worth saving if possible. But the tape that he asked me about fixing is going to be the debut 1974 Kiss. I said, absolutely, buddy, you send it my way and that baby's gonna get planned. So we'll pull out all the stops. I have parts for it if it needs to. Little experience with these, taking them apart and getting them back together. I will take some photos of the process, taking it apart and what I need to do to get this back into playing condition for Scott. So let's head to the back, open this up, and see what we can do with it.
So when Scott asked me about fixing the tape for him, I said, absolutely, you know, no problem at all. You know, I grew up with these things, and I've taken it apart ever since I was a kid, trying to save the life of these, because, you know, they're actually savable. If you have the parts for it, the time to do it. This is the one type of cartridge, though, that does not come apart with tabs. This is a heat-sealed cartridge, and you have to start from the top and start making the crack open and getting your little utility knife in there to split it as you go. What you have to do is very slowly go around with the utility knife down the side. What I usually do is keep a piece of wood in it. This way it keeps it under pressure and actually cracks the seal a little easier as you go around. What happened was the tape came apart at the splice, which I figured it would because it's the downfall of these 8-track tapes. Over time, the adhesive dries out. So I got all my parts set, ready to go. The felt tabs, splicing tape, and took the rollers out and the pressure pad, and you can see the dirt on it. This is a roll of the splicing tape that I use. I just cut about an inch off it, and what I like to do is remove even the tape from the original spool so that I don't damage it during the cleaning process. I wind it up on another empty spool, and this way I'm able to take everything apart, clean it, including the hub and the spool, and get all the dirt and graphite out of it so that, you know, when you wind it back up and put it back together, you don't have all that dirt getting back into the head of the tape player. It just makes the cold cleaning process a lot better. The sound is good, and then you don't have it gumming up your tape player. So this is a picture of it all cleaned up and ready to go back together. The next step is start winding the tape back up onto the original spool, and that's a pretty simple process. Just put them right together and start winding up the outside into the inside so that it winds up on itself. This way when you splice it together, it's in the right direction, and you know, it also helps create the right tension by doing it from one to the other. Just one constant winding, so it actually does a nice job with the tension of the tape itself. It's not too tight, it's not too loose. This is just a little video of how I do that, putting it back onto the original spool from the temporary home that I use while I'm cleaning it. And it goes quite quick, it's only a few minutes. So here is the whole tape back together. The parts are on it. I'm going ready to cut off the splicing tape and the two ends of it. You can see how the tape just came apart. So I'm gonna make two clean edges, take the old adhesive off, put it together as close as you can, and put the splicing tape on it. This is the back side to eyeball it up. I'm gonna put the other end of it back together onto the splicing tape. And there you see how the entire splice is back together now. I have it all wound up. It's back and threaded through the cartridge. It comes out of the center, around the top, past the capstan nip roller, down around the side, and back around onto the tape. So this is all ready to go. Again, just give it a quick turn to make sure there's nothing binding it and it looks okay. So I'm gonna put it together temporarily with a little bit of tape. This way I can play it before I actually have to glue it back together, because like I said, there's no tabs for this. Okay, after the test run of it, and it sounded pretty good, what I do is then I remove all the tape. It temporarily holds two sides together, the top and bottom. I'll remove that and start gluing. I use just like a very minimal amount of glue just on a couple of the points around the top edge, the sides, and the bottom. The further away from the tape, the better, since you don't want to get the glue on it. And then I put a few clamps on for a couple hours just to get it to a lot of pressure for it to dry, and then we're ready to go.
Okay, and there you go. That was as easy as 1, 2, 3. The tape is playing, sounds fantastic. It's in good condition, label, front and back, not bad at all. Put it in a fresh new carton for you, Scott, and it'll be heading back your way in no time at all. So hopefully you have an 8-track player that works and you'll be able to listen to it. So hey everybody, thanks for joining me, appreciate it. Take care, I'll talk to you guys soon.